Namashivai students, this is Pamila ma'am and today we will learn the determination of charge to mass ratio of an electron. In my last video, I have already discussed about the discovery of an electron by cathode ray experiment and also we have studied the characteristics of cathode rays. So, J.J. Thomson was able to determine the ratio of electronic charge to mass of the electron by using a cathode ray discharge tube. This is a modified cathode ray discharge tube, and he applied electrical and magnetic field perpendicular to each other as well as the path of the electrons. So we can see in this diagram he applied electrical field and magnetic field perpendicularly. In 1897, British physicist J.J. Thomson measured the ratio of electrical charge, that means E, to the mass of electron or M, by using cathode ray tube and applying electrical and magnetic field perpendicular to each other as well as to the path of electrons. Thomson argued that the amount of deviation of the particles from their path in the presence of electrical or magnetic field depends upon mainly three factors. First factor, the magnitude of the negative charge on the particle, greater the magnitude of the charge on the particle. So greater is the interaction with the electric or magnetic field, and thus greater is the deflection. So magnitude of negative charge on the particle, greater the magnitude, greater will be the deflection. Then second factor, the mass of the particle, lighter the particle, greater the deflection. Then third factor, the strength of the electrical or magnetic field, the deflection of electrons from its original path increases with the increase in the voltage across the electrodes, or the strength of the magnetic field. So if we increase the voltage across the electrodes, or if we increase the strength of the magnetic field, then the deflection of the electrons will be more. So these are the three factors on which electrons, the deflection on electrons vary. So when only electric field is applied, the electrons deviate from their path and hit the cathode ray tube at point A. Here it is at point A. This is point A. So if only electric field is applied, the electrons which are coming from cathode, they hit at point A. So they deviate towards the negative terminal of the negative electric field. Similarly, when only magnetic field is applied, electron strikes the cathode ray tube at point C. This is the point C. So if only magnetic field is applied, then the cathode rays hit the screen. This is a fluorescent screen, so this hit the screen at point C. Now, by carefully balancing the electrical and magnetic field, it is possible to bring back the electron to the path followed as in the absence of electric or magnetic field, and they hit the screen at point B. This is the point B. So if we carefully adjust the electric and magnetic field, then the cathode ray or path of electron hit the screen at point B. This is point B. By carrying out accurate measurements on the amount of deflections observed by the electrons on the electric field strength or magnetic field strength, Thomson was able to determine the value of E by M, and it was 1.75 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kg, where M is the mass of electron in kg and E is the magnitude of the charge on the electron in coulomb. This way, Thomson was able to determine the E by M ratio of an electron. Now, Millikan was another scientist. He determined the charge of an electron. From J.J. Thomson's experiment, we cannot find neither charge nor mass. So, another experiment had to be carried forward by Millikan, and it is known as Millikan's oil drop experiment. So, this is the schematic diagram of Millikan's oil drop experiment. So, in 1906, Robert Millikan was able to determine the charge of an electron in oil drop experiment. We can see the schematic diagram of his experiment. So, a source of X-ray, is placed, and source of high DC voltage is placed over here. So this is a container. And in this container, from outside and source of X-ray was set, and DC voltage was placed over here, and which is capable of providing of 10,000 volt of 10,000 voltage. An atomizer for spraying tiny oil droplet. These are oil droplets. This is an atomizer, and this can spray tiny oil droplets inside this container. And a telescope. This is a telescope to observe oil drops. Inside the container, there are two plates. Now, oil drops are sprayed on the plate. We can see that oil drops are spread on the plate. The above plate has a small hole in it, allowing droplets to enter this region. So, from this hole, the oil droplets can enter this region. The top plate is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and the and the x-ray here, and the x-ray comes from here, which ionizes the gas, which ionizes the droplets which are present here, which in turn charges the drops. So first, these x-ray, they ionize the gas present in this area or region, which in turn charges the drops in this region. Now, at first, voltage is turned off between the plates. Now, we observe the oil drops from this telescope. Now, first, they accelerate. Now, the oil drops, they accelerate due to the gravitational force, which is Fg. And then due to the viscous force, which is Fv, a steady velocity is reached due to the air inside, which acts opposite to the direction of the motion of oil drops. Now, from this experiment, Millikan determined the charge on different oil drops, and he prepared a chart by calculating the charge of different oil drops at different voltages applied. He noted that the charge of an oil drop is always an integral multiple of a minimum charge, and the minimum charge was found to be 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So from the chart, he found that the minimum charge was found to be 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Actually, the charge was considered to be due to the electrons being attached to the oil drops. So the minimum charge differs between two oil drops was taken as a charge of the electron, which was found to be 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Now, since he knew the ratio of charge to mass, he was able to determine the mass of electron. So from J.J. Thomson's experiment, the E by M ratio was already known, which was 1.76 into 10 to the power 8 or 10 to the power 11. And now he determined the charge of an electron, which is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So by dividing charge by mass, E by M ratio, he determined the mass of an electron, which is 9.10 into 10 to the power minus 19 gram. So he found from Millikan's oil drop experiment, charge of an electron is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and from J.J. Thomson's oil drop experiment, E by M ratio was found that is 1.76 into 10 to the power 8 coulomb per gram. So by dividing E by E by M, mass was determined, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 28 gram. So for today we discuss up to this. Om Namah Shivaya.